I'm hoping this works. Because this morning I didn't get anything on my phone. I actually had to look at my older phone and it got an email to say that this has happened. The only thing is, I shouldn't be getting emails on my old phone. So I quickly opened up YouTube on this phone, and it appeared in a said review later. So hopefully that it'll pop up for me to review it now. Also, this is school on Wednesday, the 22nd of September, 2021. And of course, it doesn't work. Please appear here. Oh, for God's sake. My fans of Sherlock Holmes, our team has reviewed your content, and unfortunately, we think violence are harassment, threats, and cyberbullying policy. We removed the following content from YouTube: Skull DMs, Discord, and memes on Twitter on the 20th of September 2021. Crap, that was 3 days ago. Just what had happened was that I told a bunch of people that the reason why I got a video taken down, because in the video I called Mrs. Fletcher a psycho. But it turns out that it was the video for Monday, and I didn't call her a psycho on Monday, because the incident happened on Tuesday. So this might be I've already read this with the Ray William Johnson video, but it might be a bit different, so I'm gonna read it again. This might be a bit disappointing, but it's important for us to keep YouTube a safe place. Why do I keep on doing that? If content breaks our rules, we remove it. If you think you made a mistake, you can appeal, and we'll take another look. Keep reading for more details. Instead of reading, I'm gonna see where the dispute button is, or the appeal button is. Ah, okay, there is a button. Higher content violated the policy. YouTube creators share their opinions on a wide range of different topics. However, there's a line between passionate debate and malicious harassment. Content containing target harassment, including but not limited to stalking, threats, bullying, and intimidation, is not allowed on YouTube. Additionally, content that includes erogenous insults based on personal attributes, such as protected group status or physical traits, it's not allowed on YouTube. If you're not sure whether your content crosses the line, please do not post it. We review educational, documentary, artistic, and scientific content on a case-by-case basis. Limited exceptions remain for content with sufficient and appropriate context, and where the purpose of posting is clear. I do not remember what happened on Monday for the video to get taken down. School. Probably. DMs? Let me look. So, on Monday's DMs videos, I would have covered, like, all your followers, all the way down to, you have to use for a minute or two. Maybe not even, you have to use it for a minute or two. So, there is basically nothing there for me to, you know, there's nothing there that's inappropriate. So, what else could it be? Discord. I'm gonna say no. Oh, it could be it could have been the Top Gear clip. Although I'm surprised it wasn't a copyright warning instead of a, you know, a harassment warning. Memes, let me just check. Wait, why did I say basket? Okay. I think this was the last thing I did on Monday. Maybe it was the wait, what was this one? Possibly could be memes because I talked about that you know that trend that I apparently am not allowed to mention on YouTube. I thought it was only banned on TikTok. Like I talked about this on Monday because or maybe it was yesterday. But you know, my mate did it. And he got his post taken down within, like, 5 minutes. Because he used the hashtag. So I'm guessing TikTok takes down any post with that hashtag, no matter the context. Because it's a bot that does it instead of a human. And Twitter. Could be Twitter. So do I warrant them taking it down? No. If it's DMs, Discord, memes, or Twitter? No, because that's someone else doing it. If it's school? No, because I didn't bully. I do not remember what happened on Monday, but I can guarantee you I did not bully. So this is absolute BS. Let's affect your channel. Because it's the first time, this is just a warning. What happens again, your channel will get a strike and you won't be able to do things like upload, post, or live stream for 1 week. What's the difference between uploading and posting? Also, this isn't the first time. And of course, I'm going to appeal. So, YouTuber actually let me watch the video. So, I'm going to try and decipher what it is because since it's a bot picking up on it, and I've probably said something or something that I've shown has said something that they deem harassment, I'm going to look at all of it and see what I think it could be. So, before I even started out reading the DMs talking about what happened in school, I opened up Netflix on my PlayStation and noticed that my brother had his name changed to an insult because I'm just going to re-explain it. My dad from the very start had his profile picture as Todd from BoJack Horseman and he didn't know who. You know, he just said it that randomly. He doesn't know anyone from BoJack. He doesn't even know BoJack. He wouldn't recognize BoJack. But, after I pointed out to him multiple times that it's a character from a show he doesn't like, he eventually changed it to that little devil guy from Disenchantment. And then my brother thought, I'm going to change it on him. And he changed it to a chicken. That changed the profile picture back to the devil guy and set my brother's name to an insult. I'm just going to explain everything that happens in this video like it did when the last time I had a copyright thing on one of my videos on Instagram. I reported that kid who threw the sweet behind him, but I also reported the year 11s and 12s who were throwing the mints at him. But I need you to know that these two incidents were unrelated. I tried to report what happened to the head of sixth form and he said, write a report and send it to this guy's form teacher. I wrote up the report but I forgot to send it and I still haven't sent it yet. But the situation, I think, is resolved. I think that someone else has done it for me. The reason why I've kicked out of Discord is not because of the article or what I said. It was actually because McKnight was really annoyed at something at the time, and me doing all that just sort of tipped him over the edge. I was invited back into the Discord. He sent me an invite on Discord through DMs saying, "Come home, soldier." Discount Spencer has left the server, and there's this new guy in who I don't know who he is. This is the first pause I took in the video, because McKnight had his name changed from Santa to San Witwicky or whatever from. So I paused the video so I can Google Sam Witwer, and I realized, oh, it's not Sam Witwer, it's Sam Witwicky, who is the Shia LaBeouf's character in Transformers. The audio was cut out for this. The audio immediately starts back up once I leave Google. Just by the fact I didn't even pause. Also, you could see it just a tiny bit of the Discord, but it was just like the channels and all. So I am sorry. So I read out the DMs and explain that those two videos are me explaining to him that I'm not intentionally wet my hair. It's a mixture of sweat and rain. And then putting a hair dryer in my hair. So, one of the guys in the Discord has his description as professional truck driver. And it reminded me of this of a clip from Top Gear. If you've seen the most offensive clips in the world video for Top Gear, you probably know what I'm talking about. Possibility that me talking rubbish about some of the people in this document is what they took it down for. So this girl dressed up like that Animal Crossing girl to make a TikTok with the song in the background saying, "Thank you for sexualizing my cosplay." This guy says, "This literally like if I dressed up as Kim Kardashian after the regular tape got leaked." Like, yeah, your cosplay wasn't sexualized, because if it weren't for the video, you probably wouldn't know who this person was. Or even if you did, then you wouldn't have cosplayed as her. There was the one where it's like TikTokers share glow-ups after escaping conservative households, and their apparent glow-up makes them look worse than they did when they were seemingly trapped in the conservative households. The thing on the TikTok with the hashtag has been banned because it's theft, and people are getting arrested for it. So Carson Wolf made fun of Anthony Fauci, not me. Let me just finish this, see if I did. Okay, so all I said was that it is true that Fauci has this like sort of cult following. I didn't make fun of Fauci. If anything, I made fun of his followers. But I didn't necessarily say anything about Anthony himself. But Carson said that Fauci, I'm not actually going to say what he said, I'm just going to say that Carson assaulted him, not me. This man here called the government pathetic and weak. I didn't make fun of the guy, but I just said, "Why are you whispering?" I wasn't making fun of the government, nor was I making fun of Nicki Minaj, but I just said it was a bit weird for a White House official, like, speaker or whatever, to just
even mention her name. So, the context of that video was that, now, this was mentioned in a previous Twitter video, but I didn't understand it then, until Marcus made a video on YouTube about it, which I've seen, and I understand it now. So, what had happened was that one of Nicki Minaj's, like, friends or family members took the vaccine, and it caused a certain sexual body part to swell up. And Nicki tweeted out going, this person I'm close to said that the vaccine has did this to him. Please be careful when taking the vaccine. So, you know, because of what happened to your friend or whatever, she's now skeptical about vaccines. She's not being anti-vax, because there's a difference. So, Boris Johnson was taking his advice from someone called Piers Corbyn. And when I heard about this, I initially thought that Piers Corbyn was a sort of, like, you know, I thought that Piers Morgan and Jeremy Corbyn were doing something together. So people, instead of saying Piers Morgan and Jeremy Corbyn, they're going to say Piers Corbyn. Because there's a character on that on Twitter. But it turns out that Piers Corbyn is someone's actual name. And I said, oh, I didn't know that's a real person. I thought it was just I already explained it. That's not necessarily bullying or harassment or threats. I didn't make fun of her name. It was a little offensive, I guess. But it's not, you know, it wasn't offense. It shouldn't have been offensive enough to warrant a takedown. Once again, this is something that, like, it's not offensive. I wasn't really targeting anyone. I wasn't even targeting in general. It's just something that they politically disagree with, despite the fact I didn't necessarily say anything political. Just what happened was that Kaiser Chiefs had a concert, and they got people to applaud for whatever vaccine they took. Like, you know, you have the Pfizer vaccine. And really, that's the only one I know. I'm going to create a fictional company that produces a vaccine. Fantasy Sherlock Holmes. Here's the Pfizer vaccine. Yeah! Here's the Fantasy Sherlock Holmes vaccine. Yeah! You like that? And I didn't necessarily say that it was, well, I didn't say it was stupid, I just said it's weird. This is getting off point, but I just turned around. Why is there like a documentary playing? Because I'm on episode 99 of Jane the Virgin, and the show's on for 100 episodes. And so far, I am 7 minutes into it, and it's a documentary. You know, it's sort of looking back at it, and there are some shows that I've done, that, like Friends and Castle and all, but this one's a bit different, because those ones, something has happened, and they could, like, possibly die. Well, that's just Castle. I don't remember what Friends did. They sort of trigger it, but like, with Castle, one of the characters could have died. And I sort of looked back over, like, sort of tropes in the show. Like a catchphrase or something like that. But this one's different. Yeah, so it turns out it's the whole episode. Not that I don't like stuff like this. But I thought if it was only off for a couple minutes, I'll just watch the whole thing, then get back to the video. But since it's the whole episode, no. That was such an awkward laugh. Anyway. So something that was trending on Twitter was hashtag trans women or women. And it was just a bunch of women talking about, like,
I don't even know if the tweets were pro trans or transphobic. Like it was very confusing.
Yeah, so I shouldn't have been taken down. So, oh, there we go. Okay, this is good. Although they didn't actually tell me it was taken down. Like, all the way that they want me to do something about it, yet they don't inform me. So my, from 5432 to 56 on my Nostalgia 18 video, because I watched a whole League of Gentlemen clip. Which I kind of that was like the most obvious thing you'd take down for copyright, but I still did it because I felt the fact that I was that me pausing it and going, right, it isn't funny because this and this. Watching some more, pausing it again. This isn't funny because this and this. Hopefully that then it would be seen as criticism, which you know I shouldn't be taken down for that. Because I'm not a reaction channel, because everything, like some like main reaction channels, that they watch the whole thing and don't react to it. So, video cannot be seen. I don't like the fact that a nostalgia video can't be seen, especially since it comes from something that is outside of the nostalgia part. But I really don't want to do anything about it because it is a blatant copyright. I don't know what the word is. Breach. But I really don't want a nostalgia video getting taken down because it goes like 11, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 19. Oh, you can trim it out. Yes, please trim it out. I don't know. Preview trimmed. Let me see this. So I'm just going to briefly explain the clip. So there is Steve Pemberton wearing a dress, saying, "I've told you a thousand times, I am not Dave." And Reese Shearsmith is wearing blackface, going, "Oh, Dave, just give me your ring. I told you, I am not Dave." Hold on, I have to take a pee. And by the way, what's Mark Gatiss is like wearing this cloak, and eventually he slash she takes a cloak off and goes, "I was in your position before, Jesse," when he says, "Oh, okay. So you gotta get me that ring?
Yes."
Okay, let's go then. You're my new wife now."
And that's it. Just what happened was that The League of Gentlemen are a comedy sketch group. They're like one of the, they're considered the best alongside Little Britain and Monty Python. I don't like the Monty Python show. I don't like Flying Circus. I just don't like sketch comedy. And I have never seen Little Britain. But I think most of their comedy comes from them wearing dresses, which I really don't like. So, no, I'm not watching Little Britain. So I decided, oh, I'm gonna see this comedic genius from them. So I searched up best League of Gentlemen sketch. And the first thing that popped up was a Watch Mojo video of the best moments. But really what they mean is the best sketches. And number one was that one. It was crap. And it was racist. So, yeah. So I got an email back about the appeal, which was actually really quick, like, holy crap. Oh, thanks to Sherlock Holmes, who reviewed your appeal for the long content in that video. I particularly would confirm that your content does not violate our community guidelines. Thanks for your patience while we review this appeal. Our goal is to make sure that content doesn't violate our community guidelines so that YouTube can be a safe place for all. And sometimes we make mistakes trying to get it right. We're sorry for any frustration that our mistake may have caused you, and we appreciate you letting us know how this affects your channel. We've reinstated your content. If your appeal was for a warning, you'll be allowed another warning in the future. So maybe that's why I don't actually know if the Ray William Johnson video got put back up or not. Anyway. Your appeal was for a strike. We've removed the strike against your channel. Good. Thank you very much. YouTube is way better at this than Instagram. This DMs as of 7 PM on Wednesday the 22nd of September 2021. The reason why I freaked out when they played Fun is because Fun is my sixth favourite band. I know, it's fine to freak out. I realised after you explained it to me. Oh, okay.
Here, Mr. Manward?
How should I know? Go ask your persnickety fry cook. Between him and this other idiot, we're not gonna make it through the lunch rush alive.
Well, I'll just see about that. You'll be having the number three with cheese.
Oh, that's what I was gonna order. I'll have the number cheese with cheese.
Don't you have somewhere else to be a nitwit?
One, two, four.
Restaurant for the hungry customers out there. Where are their burgers?
Mr. Slabs, you know that I can't serve a slabby patty until it's cooked just right. Slabby patty and cooked just right. Slabby patty day and night. What a nifty, tasty sight. Slabby patty.
That's the first time I've actually seen Clancy Brown do the Mr. Krabs voice, like IRL. Because, you know, I've heard Mr. Krabs, and I've seen Clancy in, like, The Flash and Emergence and all. And I knew that he was voicing Mr. Krabs. It was just hard to imagine him doing that. But if they can get all the actual SpongeBob actors to do, like, a real-life thing, why couldn't they get the actual actors from Rick and Morty to do the real-life Rick and Morty? Because they had to get Christopher Lloyd to do Rick, which was a little weird. I mean, I understand why they did it, but still, it's just weird. I sent this a story, but I don't remember what the story was. And because my mate was looking at something on Instagram, and someone else pointed out that there's like a bra strap or something. So I just DM'd him saying, sus. This memes as of 1 to 7 PM on Wednesday, 22nd of December 2021. I can't play this clip because it uses Mr. Brightside by The Killers. I know it's a little uninteresting when you can't actually hear the song, but just like play it or something, I guess, with this video on mute. Rainbow Six streamers swear more than any other type of content creators till he finds.
Yes. Because Siege is the most tactical multiplayer game. So if you land like Fortnite, which requires, let's say Call of Duty, if you land Call of Duty, it's just, oh, okay. But if you land Siege after all that planning, no, it's like, you know, it just all went to waste. So that's why you swear more. Although my uncle does swear a lot, but he dies once in COD. Like, all these effing campers. I don't know if what he's saying is true or not, because I don't watch him play COD. I can just hear it from... He's upstairs in his room, I'm downstairs in the living room watching whatever. This Twitter, as of 2:07 PM on Wednesday the 22nd of September 2021. Nearly done. Let's go. What's this about Crash Bandicoot? Wait, what happened on September 9th, 2021? So, once again, not trending. Once again, not trending. I'm gonna guess once again not trending. Once again not trending. Okay, so maybe this one actually is trending because they're saying, I don't want this thing from Hunter Biden. I want this thing of Donald Trump, because I'm biased as hell, and something negative towards Hunter Biden is going to be negative towards his dad, President Joe Biden, who we support, and we don't want Trump back in, despite the fact that literally no one supports Joe Biden. Why is it doing this? There we go. Trans species man who self-identifies as deer accident shot by hunter, South Carolina man identifies. Self-identifies as a deer has been transported to the hospital via helicopter after being shot by two hunters. They need to stop killing him. We stand with Israel. How about stand with your own nation instead? Every time Pinocchio lied, his nose got bigger. ID software, like shit software. I didn't swear. Guys want to smash capitalism but get defeated by type 2 diabetes. Where did Ghost thing go? I need is all that, please. See him. Huge group of construction workers protesting against forced vaccine block highway in Melbourne. King energy.